Good morning. Today I will tell you about algebra. This is a new term for you. See, algebra is a branch of mathematics. You can see here, you have already gone through so many branches. One is arithmetic, one is geometry, and one is algebra. These three I have written here because these are familiar to you. Arithmetic is dealing with the numbers. Numbers are what? 10, 20, 100, 9. These are the numbers. You can see another number here. 8.5, that is decimal number. 5 by 9, that is fraction. Okay, now I can go to the geometry. Geometry is what? It's always, when we see the geometry, it is dealing with the shapes. Shapes are what? Any shapes, you can tell me. The like triangle, rectangle, any 3D shapes, sphere, square, etc. These are dealing with the shapes. Now I will come, that is algebra. Algebra is dealing with the letters. The letters are denoted by the English alphabets. A, B, P, Q. I have written some example here. N, N, T, etc. But here you have seen there is no numbers. That means they are not fixed. They are not fixed. They are variables. So we have always dealing in algebra that dealing with variables because they don't have any fixed value. So next part I will show you how the variable are working. See, I have given one name, that is matchsticks pattern. See, matchsticks pattern, I have used some matchsticks. I can draw, and I have already drawn a triangle. You can see one triangle, I have used three matchsticks. Second triangle is again 1, 2, 3, both together are 6 triangles. Third is again 3, 1, 2, 3 matchsticks. They are 3 triangles and 1, 2, 3. 3 threes are 9 triangles is the total. You can go on like this up to anything. But when we are giving the largest number, suppose 30 matchsticks, 60 matchsticks, how will you count? It will be very lengthy. So we always use some formula. We can count it in this way also, but always we have to give it a table. But in algebra, we can use some variables. See, I have written number of matchsticks equal to n. That means any number, you can see here, 2 into n. Number of matchsticks is 10, n. If I know that number of matchsticks, so I can count any number. See, I have given you one example and you have some homework also. How to create the formula? I have written letter L. How many matchsticks are there? 2 matchsticks. How will you write? You can write the formula 2N. The T is there. How many matchsticks are there? 1 or 2. How will you write? 2N. For Z, how will you write? 1, 2, 3. That is 3N. For E, you can write 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4N. So this is the way you can create the formula and go on. This is my first session. I will go next session with expression, terms and algebraic equation. Thank you.